Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm the host, if you want to call me that, Damon Pettit. And today, I'm going to be doing a review, not so much of an actual one cigar, but of pretty much Cigar Company, the company that makes it, the people behind it. I am also doing, I'm on Meerkat, so you watching on YouTube or wherever you're watching, my website, whatever, doesn't really matter because it's all over with, but the people over here on Meerkat know, or the person, it's not like I have a huge thing over here right now, but we are going to smoke this Ezra Zion cigar. And this is, I do not know anything about this actual blend of cigar, other than I did have one a few days ago, and I did enjoy it. It was a cigar that I think that they made just for the event that they had, and they go around, not exactly sure. I really probably, since I was there talking with Kyle from Ezra Zion Cigars, I probably should have asked him, a few questions. But I kind of got a little bit, just kind of listening to things he had to say, and of course he had other people there that he was talking to, and I was listening to all of them and their stories, so I was just kind of sitting there like an idiot, but what you gonna do? Roll too late now. I'm gonna pair this with some Ezra Zion coffee. And very, very delicious coffee. I believe that they're gonna come out with this coffee and sell it at some at some point. So when they do, I can guarantee you I will be a buyer of that coffee. I am being very high class and drinking out of a lid. But let's at least get this thing rolling, and I'm going to have my usual fun time sitting here flip-flopping my gums and talking about shit that I like. Wow. First of all, I'm going to start off by saying, if you haven't had an Ezra Zion cigar, more than likely for your taste, for everybody's taste, you're missing something. They are individual. Sorry, I have something on my tongue that won't come off. They are individual little kind of works of art, so to speak. I always liked their little their bands, their whole entire branding. It's great. Works well for what I like, that's for sure. And these cigars, wow. I've had all of their cigars, and the way that they come about or go about making their cigars, something that I don't know how many different, cigar companies work at it like they do or go about it the way they do. Not saying that they're the only ones that want a quality cigar, but they're passion is actually having the best cigar that you've ever had. And that's what they want, you know. Whether in your opinion that they hit that mark or not, that's always up to everybody's individual palate. But so far, everybody that I've seen try an Ezra Zion cigar really does kind of like one of these, like, wow, you know. And I remember the very first one I had. It was actually one that I was getting ready to go on vacation. It was the day before. It was like that evening was my start of my vacation. But I was getting ready to go on a trip. So that whole thing, and then the kickoff with an excellent cigar, was fantastic for me. And so that kind of, you know, started a positive thing for my brain and their cigars. And then I continued to, you know, smoke their different cigars now that they do have. And every one of them has been just absolutely fantastic. The quality of the actual taste in the tobacco, just the aroma from the smoke itself. This last week, I went to one of their, I don't know what you call it, a cigar event, and really cool place, way the hell out in in the south part of Arizona. It took me like 40, 45 minutes to get there, and usually I'm pretty ready to just wanted to look at some during the week I like to try to get to bed at a certain time, you know, so that I'm not tired real bad the next day. And the next day I had to, you know, be at work by 5. But I went to this event, got there by 8:30 or something like that. I figured I'd be there about a half an hour. I'd say hi to Kyle, who was there, and get to meet him, buy a couple cigars, and get the hell out of there. I didn't end up leaving until 12:15 or something like that. Got home. Got to bed about 1:30. Actually, I got to bed about 2. And but honestly, there's a few things about that night. Is had one of these cigars. Everybody was smoking cigars, of course. And it had been a while since I'd eaten, so I had a very empty stomach. And I was like, okay, I'm just getting ready to smoke a cigar here. Might be a stronger cigar, and not exactly, I don't know how I'm going to do it, you know, like, is it going to make me, cigars are so excellent. I had absolutely no problems whatsoever. It was an excellent night. Just being able to listen to some of the things that, you know, go on. I know a lot of you have probably gone and visited, you know, different places that actually make cigars. You've gone to the different, you know, big things in Vegas or wherever, and met a lot of the different people. But I haven't. And so this was, besides meeting Abbo, I haven't really met anybody else. And and just the passion that these guys have to turn out a cigar that you're going to love is honestly, it makes me want to find all those different kind of cigar people that are in that frame of mind. Everybody's in it, you know, to make a buck or two, to make a good living, to make a damn good living. Everybody wants to, you know, be respected in whatever they do. Everybody wants to make the money. But being able to actually have a huge passion for something and then not settle for the shit, that to me is excellence. And I always want to find those kind of people. If I'm going to buy wine, if I'm going to buy a cigar, if I'm going to buy coffee, you know, I always look for those things, for those kind of people that have that passion to actually have, you know, a good product and want to really do the right thing as far as making it the right way. The different things that they do when they go out there, and they don't, you know, they treat people with respect, and that to me is huge. You know, no matter what you're doing or what kind of you know, environment you're in, you want to treat the people, especially your customers, but the people that are on your team, the people that are helping you make your product, helping you put out a product, if you treat them with respect and give them something to feel good about, they're going to give you their best, and so you're going to have an excellent product coming out every time. And so, you know, if you go to smoke an Ezra Zion cigar, and you smoke another one, you smoke another one, you smoke another one, you smoke, and everyone you have is an excellent cigar, smokes great, looks great, feels great, you know, great draw, great look, great feel, great taste, great burn, if all that is always, get my mic there, if all those are always on the top part of things, then they must be doing something right to the people or for the people that are actually making the product. Because if you got a bunch of pissed off rollers, you know, you're going to have some bad cigars coming out of there. You know, you get, walk through there and you say, hey, Roller John, yeah, step it up a little bit, huh? We need to make some extra cash. Roller John isn't going to be so happy. So, there are so many different angles and twists and stuff like that when it comes to business and when it comes to this little thing called a cigar, you know? I don't know. If you're watching this and saying, this motherfucker's just having, he's doing a commercial for Ezra Zion. I am doing something, this is a start of something that I'm going to be doing going forward. I'm going to be talking about not only reviewing cigars, that'll be pretty much the main thing I do, which is, I think a lot of people, I don't know if a lot of people think I'm actually reviewing a cigar. I think a fair amount do, but from here on out, I'm also going to find the different cigar companies, people that have that passion, and talk them up. And Ezra Zion Cigars, I'm not going to lie, it probably might be my favorite cigar. Definitely. I'd have to say that they are, based on the cigars I smoke from them, based on what I've always kind of come to know as far as, you know, reading about them, all that different kind of crap, just based on all those things put together, along with meeting Kyle and then learning some of the backstories of stuff, they're on the top for me. And if there's a company out there that's like them, that puts in that much more or something like that, then, you know, let them try to be on the top. But to me, it doesn't matter, you know, best, better, any of that kind of thing. For me, for my taste, for the things that I like, for the things that I have a passion for, Ezra Zion Cigar is my favorite right now. So, and for the most part, they have been for a long time, but, you know, it's not the only cigars I smoke. I smoke pretty much whatever I can. I don't have that much time all the time to smoke a cigar, so, you know, I want to review as many different cigars as I can. I'm getting all caught up in my cord here. It just helps that something that I actually like is actually has a whole backstory of good shit about it. So that is very nice. And I mean, it's nice for me because it, you know, I feel good about buying the product, that kind of thing. And to me, that kind of thing is what is going to help keep the cigar industry strong, going to keep it alive, going to keep it extremely, extremely, oh yeah. Extremely valuable in people's lives. Now, you know, I've always, I was kind of wondering for a while back in the day how long, you know, if the cigar industry was going to tank and people were going to kind of quit smoking them, that kind of thing. And I wasn't really worried about it, I just wondered about it. But it seems like it's really strong. The cigar place that I went to that other day, along with the other cigar stores that I've always gone to, they're growing, and they're, you know, they get more and more in. There are a lot of good cigar makers out there, a lot of great cigar makers out there, and it's fun to see it being one thing that I am a little bit passionate about as far as something that I really enjoy. It really helps to see that different good stuff going on. These cigars are just, they have some really nice, a whole lot of, like, it's a punch. It's just a nice flavor on the tongue. No acidity going through it or anything. It's pretty nice. Take a quick little break right here. I'm in Old Scottsdale. There's a place I was the other day, and I'm right down the street from that. The place that I was before is just down that way somewhere. And so where I am right now is it's a actual, got a little close to my face, sorry about that. It's never a good thing. I'm on the patio of a restaurant that's closed Sunday night. Luckily they're closed. And hoping I won't get kicked away. I don't think I will. I was telling Meerkat people that. There was one person, Mark, that was watching at the point, and saying I hope I don't get kicked out, but I really don't think I will. Knock on some sort of wood, my box up here. one thing that makes me happy, and we'll see. I don't know anything like that. If it's their Ezra Zion plans or anything, I have no idea. But they did. They do have, or might be having, or do have, or going to have a coffee line, and that's what I'm drinking right now. And it's excellent. It's very good. So, if they do, in fact, start selling Ezra Zion coffee, I will be a purchaser of that coffee. I don't know if I already said that or not. I think I might have. But, it's definitely something to keep your eyes open. Every cigar so far that I have smoked from Ezra Zion have been excellent draw, you know, and not that don't have a really, really easy draw that almost burns your face off. Don't have a too hard. I've never had one with a hard draw in any way. You know, you really, if I was wearing a hat, my hat would be off to them. Definitely a good thing. But getting back to just the whole cigar industry and the way it is, it's very interesting. It's an exciting thing to see. Like I said, it's growing, but you have your people that have been in it forever. Avo being one of them. And see, the thing is, for me, when I'm buying things like that, it helps to know the whole backstory of the actual people, of the actual company, the ones that get bought out or whatever by a ginormous other entity of some sort. It kind of takes the romance of the cigar making away from me. It's, I don't know. The way it's done, it's such a delicate process, you know, just you got the whole little tiny seeds, grow little tiny plants, grow up into bigger plants, the whole thing. And then one day, wherever you are, you're smoking one, all those leaves wrapped up, you're smoking them, and it's driven by people who have a passion to have a business and to also have a product that people literally have to like your product in order to buy it. They're not going to just, not like a cigarette thing where it's almost, they have to buy cigarettes after some point, you know. I've never been a cigarette smoker, so I don't know that draw or whatever it is that people feel like they have to have their cigarette. I love to smoke cigars. I don't have to smoke them. It's never been anything where if every cigar in the world just disappeared, I'd be okay. You know, it's not the end of my life. I'd feel really bad for everybody who's in the industry, but it wouldn't be the end of my life. I would be fine. I'd go on. I'd probably miss the times where sitting back having a nice cigar, but I don't believe that'll ever happen. But the whole thing with cigars is that they're that delicate process and having them hand rolled by a human being and having those people who live a much different life than, at least I'm thinking, most of the people that smoke the cigars. And I think a lot of us would be complaining a lot if we were one of those cigar rollers. I don't know. I don't know their life. I would love to you know, do a day in the life of a cigar roller just to see. They have to probably be with them, spend a week or a month or whatever, just to get kind of a taste of what it is that they have to go through every day in their life to sustain their life, to sustain their family, you know, their dreams, their hopes, whatever, you know, however that works for them where they are. And then to be able to make something that people can get so much enjoyment for, you know? I just hope that maybe that they somehow know that what they do down the line, people say, you know, that they understand that people are buying their cigars, the cigars that they're making, for many different pleasurable events, for celebrations, for for events, you know, going out golfing, and having poker games, people going to Vegas, so they go buy a bunch of cigars, and there's usually always, for a lot of people, a fun event or something fun going on, and that's why they're smoking that cigar. A lot of people like me just want a few moments to sit back, relax, have that interaction with, you know, with your thoughts, with the cigar that you're smoking, get to have that individual taste, the different taste come through from whatever you're drinking, whatever you're eating, whatever you were eating. Making sure that that's going to be the end of it for. Apparently, he needed to get that out of his system. Let me rewind that because I have no idea where I was. But anyway, yeah, just to be able to, you know, sit back with your thoughts, relax. Enjoy the cigar, you know? I don't know. It's just, sorry, that whole thing threw me off. The whole reason that most of us are, you know, choosing to smoke a cigar or whatever, whether it's just to, you know, there's a small percentage of them that are, people are smoking them because they want to look cool walking down the street, whatever, you know. I think the biggest percentage of people are the ones like me that want to relax, hang out, read a book, smoke a cigar, watch a movie, smoke a cigar. You know, the other people that buy them for celebrations to where they have a huge dinner, then everybody sits back and, you know, smokes their cigar and they all talk. And so all these cigars are building all these different memories, you know. All these different people have these different memories of the certain cigars that they've smoked. And so these people that have rolled these cigars, you know, had all that different, that they have no, I don't know if they have any idea, any clue as to the positive energy that they end up creating through their actions. And if they did, I don't know, I hope that somehow some of them do know that, or all of them do, but I don't know, you know. Maybe somebody out there can tell me. Do they know? I don't know. But I found it interesting that Because that's something I've always thought, is that the, you know, the cigar roller is the one of the unsung heroes in the whole cigar industry. You have all these, you have the reps that go out there and, you know, they get to know people. You have the actual cigar owners of the companies that go around, and they're meeting people, and, you know, they're creating a rapport, and they leave either a positive or negative vibe or whatever it is. But these other people that are rolling the cigars, nobody knows who they are. Nobody has a clue. And if people did not know how to roll cigars, I wouldn't be sitting here, would I? Whatever you're doing, if you're sitting back or if you're smoking a cigar right now, think about that. Think about where that cigar has been, how it's gone from a seed in a different country, Nicaragua, Dominican Republic, Honduras, wherever it is, and it's gone through the cycles of life on Earth, from, you know, being born as a little tiny plant and then being nurtured, given water, the sun, and all that. And then it comes time for its actual growing part has come to an end. And then the whole cycle of the, you know, the curing and stacking and the wrapping and the pudding and the all the different things that the tobacco goes through, the tobacco leaf, each individual leaf. And then it goes and goes to the tables of the rollers. And then you have those individual people taking those leaves, rolling them, and then it gets put into however, wherever the hell it goes from there. See, I don't even know. That's the thing. And then, it, you know, guessing at some point, obviously, they get put in the boxes, wrapped up, shipped away. Your favorite cigar store, or one of your five favorite cigar stores ends up, you know, ordering them from whatever company. Ezra Zion, whoever, and they put them on their shelf. You walk in, you say, let me give that shit a try. You buy the cigar, light it up, you're like, wow, very nice. All that for this moment. It's pretty crazy. I don't know if there is a product that goes through those many different stages with that kind of care. You know, I mean, you have wine that is, you know, carefully grown and stuff, but not quite the same rate. You know, the tobacco is usually aged at least 2 years. You know, for most cigars, and probably way beyond that with a lot of them. So it's probably one of the hugest reasons why I chose to decide to start smoking cigars in the first place. I remember thinking I wouldn't mind trying a cigar, and I think the main reason why is back in the day I was you know, I used to read a lot about people like Arnold Schwarzenegger and stuff, and obviously he's a huge cigar smoker, so that I think that drew me to thinking about smoking a cigar. I remember the first cigar I ever smelled, I was like, holy shit, you know, not smoking anything at all, that was just kind of like, wow, you know. And so I finally decided to go ahead and start trying them. I liked it, and then reading about how they're made, and I wanted to make sure I wasn't buying something that was like a cigarette in any way. I didn't want anything like that at all. And I didn't know, you know, I'm pretty much I'm putting it in my body, I'm tasting it, that kind of thing, and you know, I don't want to end up being something that's, you know, throwing something down my gullet that's really, 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 really shitty. Little did I know, though, that I would find this kind of thing, to where, I mean, I had no idea back in the day that that is the kind of thing that I would find an actual product that took so long and so much care just to be able to actually make a cigar. I don't know. Somebody back there actually on a skateboard now, which is perfect. It's beautiful out here. Today, though, was a day that really kind of blew me away. Usually, right now, it's usually in the low 90s, and then it usually starts to get into the hundreds, and then, but today, it was like high of 70. And, kind of blows me away when you find people that are riding their skateboard on a Sunday night in a place like Old Scottsdale, and they're like almost 30 years old. It's kind of crazy. I always expect it to be, you know, like a teenage kid that's trying to train for something. Not that guy. But anyway, the weather, fucking nice. It is, it's probably like 62 right now, which here is pretty cool. And I honestly thought, earlier today it was raining, and I thought I was going to be probably wearing a hoodie or something like that, because the wind was blowing, so it felt pretty cool out. But it is beautiful out here, and I know the coolness is going to be going bye-bye pretty soon, because I think later in this week it's supposed to get into the hunt, you know, about 100 degrees, so I'm going to enjoy it while I can. At least the thing with me is I don't mind the heat, so come on, bring that shit on, all right? Gotta have more. I love the way different things enhance and can change the flavor of your cigar. Just like anything else, you know, if you have wine and you have a certain kind of food with it, you're going to be like, damn, this food tastes, and then you have something else with it, and it's like, well, wine tastes different. Yeah, it's all that shit tastes so much different when you drink something different with it or you eat something different with it. That's why you always have to take a grain of salt, maybe, if you want to call it that, you know, people's reviews, whether they write them, whether it's on video, whether, you know, smoke signals, whatever, however it is you see your different cigar reviews. You know, if one of them are sitting there eating the ass out of a donkey, and then they, you know, they're telling you that they're, cigar for some reason tastes a lot like, you know, manure, might be a reason for it. But really, you know, just always know that when you're gonna smoke a cigar, if you're somebody that doesn't smoke them a lot or is thinking about it, it's going to really be, your palate's going to be completely different than, you know, the guy across the street. Unless you guys eat exactly the same meals all the time, you're going to have different tastes come through. So, just, you can kind of use those different tastes that people throw out there as possibilities that might come through when you're smoking a cigar, but, you know, you can't, if you're hearing these different things come out, like, you know, if I'm telling you, oh, I get, you know, a little hint of wood, a hint of coffee, a hint of licorice, those are a lot of things that, you know, I have eaten or I do eat, with the exception of the wood. I'm not really a wood eater. I've had a toothpick or two in my mouth now and then, but that's really about as far as that goes. Let's not even go the other direction. Definitely the Ezra Zion cigar. Oh, fucking nice. Something that's I'm definitely enjoying. I'm really, really surprised that this, I had no idea that this place was here. And I'm really glad that it's closed. And it's not shut down, it's just closed for the evening. So I get to enjoy their seating area. Many people walk by. I wouldn't mind if somebody came up and said hi, as long as they're not trying to kick me out of here. I started by, I went up into this parking garage, Nordstrom's, and I thought I was going to, they had these tower things, and I thought, oh, that, you know, that'd be pretty cool, I could kind of see over Old Scottsdale and that kind of shit, but went up there, no, absolutely, it wasn't going to happen. I'd have to hang from a bar, and I don't really work for Cirque du Soleil, so. See if there's anything else that I want to talk about in this review, besides the wonderfulness of Ezra Zion, all their cigars, all their different things that I hope that they continue with. The best thing for me for Ezra Zion are the people behind it. And that's something that, you know, I think it's kind of important. I know that I work for a company that a lot of people love, a lot of people kind of respect, they think different things of it. And when you know some of the stuff on the other side of it, it kind of always makes me wonder, so if they knew this, would they still be, as in, you know, all happy and ready to buy your product, you know? Somebody is on Meerkat is wanting to see a close up. This is the Ezra Zion cigar, and it's a they have different cigars. This one is not one that's like on sale. They made them specifically for their event, as far as I know, anyway. So, but there are many different ones that you'll want to check out. Honestly, definitely worth it. The whole world with don't think you can kind of hear that, but there's a golf cart going by, and they had like circus music, so, but the whole the whole thing with Meerkat and what's the other one? I can't remember now. Periscope. Pretty cool things, you know. I can sit there, I'm streaming while I'm making my cigar review, TV review video. So people are, a couple people are watching me live, either laughing at me or whatever, I don't know. And then you're watching whenever you decide to watch.
Wow.
The aroma of the cigar is fantastic. For me, that's one way I can really tell a quality cigar is by the aroma that comes from it, from the smoke. If somebody is smoking a shitty cigar, and by shitty I mean really, really shitty, you can tell the difference when you smell it. And anytime I you know, get a whiff of a actual truly nice cigar, it's just like, yeah, that's nice. It's kind of like walking. For me, anyway, if I walk up into the mountains and I can smell the pine needles, and that brings back certain memories for me, that I just love that smell. So I'm sure that everybody has smells in their memory bank somewhere that they really, really wish that they either could smell again or would never smell again. I've got a few of those really bad smells locked right in here and hope I never smell them again, but
wow.
Tell you what, this is a pretty fucking nice night for me. It's beautiful outside. See tons of green plants and plants with little pink flowers on them, and then the man-made shit, which actually looks pretty cool around here. Palm trees and little lights wrapped around the palm trees. Yeah, pretty nice night for me. And always a good cigar always kind of tops that off for me. And if you smoke cigars regularly for the enjoyment of them, then definitely take a look at the Ezra Zion cigar just for yourself, you know. Don't worry about what I say about it. You can sit there, wash your mind, throw everything I've said, throw it out. Try one. And see for yourself, honestly. Everybody's going to have their own opinion about it, about every cigar out there. But you know, if you wonder, give it a try, and I have a feeling you'll have a pretty positive experience. I would literally be shocked if you don't. But it does, like I was saying, it does really help to know something about what goes on, what really goes on, you know, with the different people, with the company, in anything that you buy and anything that you do. If you know what their aim is, you know, you have the really horrible companies out there that are in it not only for the money, well, pretty much only for the money, for the power, whatever it is. You know, and then you have the companies that are backed by people who have a passion for whatever product it is that they have out there, for whatever it is that they want to sell. Sure, they want to make money. We all do. Everybody wants to make some sort of cash. And, you know, that's definitely in America, that's the main thing. That's what it's all about, you know. And to me, you know, sometimes it's extremely sad that takes precedence over everything else, you know. It's a sad thing, but it is the way kind of things are right now, or for the most part. And if you work, if right now you are working either for yourself and you have that passion and you are making money and you are, if every day that you go to work you're not really working because you enjoy it so much, you have a good thing going. And then other people who are working, you have a good thing going because you do have employment, because you're able to eat, you're able to buy a cigar, you know. But you know, if you're able to find a company or people or whatever that you work for that treat you with respect, dignity, that kind of give you a pride for yourself, for what you're doing, that to me is huge too, you know. And I remember one of the best jobs I ever had had nothing to do with money at all. I actually, this was a long time ago, but I pretty much got rid of most of everything that I had. I started working this, doing this one job that I freaking loved, just to be a, you know, I was around a certain group of people in a certain area that was just incredible, and it was probably one of the best working experiences and times of my life. And then, of course, the corporate part of the place that I worked at got changed around. The people that were around me all went bye-bye, and that the actual environment that I was in stayed the same, but the people and everything around it changed and went straight into the toilet. And so then it was time for me to move on. But if it hadn't have been for all that going on, I'd probably still be at that place, which is good and not good, because I don't know. Nothing not good about it, I guess. It just, who knows? You know, I wasn't getting paid great, that's for sure. But I didn't really care that much at that point either. Now I do. Percent excellent motherfucking cigar right here. All you gotta look at that label. You don't have to worry about what cigar it is. Just find this label on a cigar. The best way, honestly, to find an Ezra Zion cigar is to go on their website. I think you would, you know, on the top is their menu. Go to retailer. Put in where you are, which is smart if you put in, you know, a different state. Eh. So just put in where you are and find it, and then go buy some cigars that you usually buy and buy one of these to give it a try. You'll see what I'm saying. And if they ever do sell coffee, I'm right on board with that shit. Because I enjoy all kinds of different coffee as long as it has a nice flavor, that kind of thing. I like Pete's coffee, the Major Dickinson's blend, have that a lot. But this coffee is really great. There's a lot of different coffees out there that I've had that I've liked, a lot that I don't. Looks like I'm coming to the end of another review, or another cigar review TV video. But this cigar, you gotta see, yeah, it's almost an hour long. That's unbelievable. Part of it's the cigar, you know. I could probably sit here another however long this is gonna take me to smoke. But I think I've flapped my gums enough for this review, and I hope everybody is doing great. I hope you're enjoying life, enjoying doing whatever it is that you're doing, if you say this all the time, but it's just the fucking truth. If you happen to be in a really shitty place in life, you know, try to find that one little seed floating around in there that's got a little bit of positive shit in it. Pick it out and start building on that one little positive note, you know? And before you know it, you'll be back in the groove and enjoying things and stuff like that. It's just those hard times, not easy to get through. Definitely not fun, but we always come out a better person and stronger because of it once you actually get through it. So stick with it, as hard and as shitty as it might be, and, you know, there's a lot of crap going out there, but trust me, there's somebody that does really care. There really is. I think that there are a lot of people out there that don't think that, you know? And sometimes if I get really down, you know, and if I think real about something, I know that there's people that do care. And, you know, it's easy to try to throw a shit blanket over yourself and think, there's not one person that cares about me. If I die right now, nobody's going to care, blah, blah, blah. There is somebody that's going to care. Trust me. No matter how much you want to believe that nobody does, somebody does. So for the most part, just have a great day. Have a great afternoon. Have a great Christmas. Whatever day it is that you're watching this, enjoy it. Enjoy your day. Thank you for watching. I mean, for the most part, really, thank you for watching. You know, an hour worth of me sitting here just looking at you and talking. That's pretty rough. But I appreciate you actually watching. And feel free to comment. Feel free to tweet me. Feel free to email me. Whatever it is, go ahead and do it. And if it's, you know, if you want to tell me how much I should be giving you your hour back of life, just do it in a nice way. So go out there, if you smoke cigars, find a cigar, sit back, relax, just think of all the good shit, you know? Think of all the good stuff. Just for that hour, hour and a half, however long as it takes you to smoke that cigar, think of all the good stuff. Some negative shit that tries to flow into your head, push it out. Start thinking of some good thing that's going on somewhere. There's something good that happened. Either way, have a good one. I look forward to smoking with you again soon. And I'm going to relax and enjoy the rest of this. And hang out on Meerkat for, I don't know, there might be one person still watching. Take care. Have a good one.